Welcome to Math with Professor V. In this video, we're going to learn about factorials. What are they and how to simplify expressions involving factorials? So the expression n with an exclamation point after it, the way you read that out loud is you say n factorial. So you don't yell, you don't go n. And n factorial is the product of all the consecutive integers from n down to 1. So for example, 1 factorial is just equal to 1. 2 factorial is equal to 2 times 1, and then that would just simplify to 2. 3 factorial would be 3 times 2 times 1, which is 6. Do you see the pattern? Good. And then 4 factorial, that's 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which comes out to 24, etc. Now, by definition, 0 factorial is equal to 1. And let me tell you, when I first learned that, it didn't feel right. It really didn't. I was like, I just have this gut feeling it should be 0, but that's not true. So what did Professor V do? Professor V came home and asked her mom, who's also a math professor, about 0 factorial. And my mom showed me this, and so I'm going to show it to you as well. I want you to observe that n factorial we can write as n times n minus 1 factorial. And if you're saying, whoa, 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 that's quite the leap there. How did you get that? Well, let's look at a few examples so you can kind of believe it in your heart. For example, 7 factorial, that's 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Yes? Well, all of this over here, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, that's just 6 factorial, isn't it? So I could write 7 factorial as 7 times 6 factorial. You can write n factorial as n all by itself times n minus 1 factorial. Similarly, 8 factorial is 8 times, instead of 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I can just have 7 factorial. Okay, so hopefully now you're good with n factorial is n times n minus 1 factorial. And as long as n is not 0, then we're allowed to go through and divide by it on both sides, divide by n. And why do I want to do that? Because it's going to cancel out here. And then now I have n minus 1 factorial all by itself equals n factorial over n. So I'm just going to flip the order that I'm writing it. N minus 1 factorial equals n factorial over n. Good? Okay, so now I have an expression for n minus 1 factorial. I want you to go ahead and now let's let n equal 1, okay? So I'm going to substitute in 1 for that n. So 1 minus 1 factorial equals, remember I'm substituting in 1 for n, 1 factorial divided by 1. And you guys, this 1 minus 1 is inside the parentheses. 1 minus 1, that's 0 factorial, is equal to 1 factorial divided by 1. That's just 1 divided by 1, which is 1. Voila. And then I calmed down and I said, okay, I guess 0 factorial is 1. It's not a super formal proof, but hopefully it helps you believe it in your heart, right? You don't want to see these math facts and go, that feels made up. No, it's very, very real. Okay, so now that you know what a factorial is, let's practice simplifying expressions with factorials that you'll encounter. If you're an algebra student, then you'll see it for a lot of things like probability, counting, the binomial theorem. If you're a calculus student who's watching this video for a refresher, it's probably because you're working with sequences and series and doing the ratio test. Or other sorts of things that involve series with factorials in them. So this will help get you up to speed if you need it. First thing, we're gonna simplify all of these expressions completely. And a big hint when you're simplifying expressions with factorials is you usually wanna break down the larger factorial expression. And I'll show you right now what I mean by that, okay? So the like nastiest way to simplify 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial is to find out what each of these are, right? List it out and then simplify. But we're not going to do that. We're going to be clever. Which one's the larger of the two? It's 5 factorial. So I'm going to start breaking it down, but not all the way. 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. But I'm going to stop here. And instead of writing 3 times 2 times 1, I'm going to write 3 factorial. Why did I stop there? Because I see a 3 factorial on the denominator. And I go, let me stop right there. And then now I can come through and just cancel these two out and not waste my time listing out everything. And then boom, all you have left is 5 times 4, which is 20. See how painless? Oh, love it. Okay, now it's not as nice when you have subtraction, 6 factorial minus 5 factorial. So you could sit there, expand 6 factorial, figure out what it is. Expand 5 factorial, figure out what it is. That's one option. Another thing you could do, especially like if you don't have a calculator, which most of you don't, I will break down 6 factorial. It's 6 times 5 factorial minus 5 factorial. And now 5 factorial is a common factor that I can factor out. So if I take out 5 factorial, then I'm left with 6 minus 1. If I factor 5 factorial from itself, I just get 1. So then now I have 5 factorial times just another 5 like this. And then there's nothing else nice to do. You just got to sit there and go, okay, 5 factorial, that's 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, and then times another 5. 5 factorial, I've done it so many times, I know it's just 120, but you might need to sit there and think about it. So then this is 120 times 5, which is 600. All right, good. Let's try another one. Remember, break down the larger one. So we have 7 factorial divided by 6 factorial. So the larger one is 7 factorial. I'm going to break it down. It's 7 times, don't write 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just write 6 factorial over 6 factorial. Boom, boom. And we're just left with 7. That's it. That was satisfying, wasn't it? Okay, here's another one where we've got 2 factorial expressions in the denominator. So I'm gonna get the most bang for my buck if I break down the largest one, 8 factorial, and I cancel it with the larger of the 2 factorials here. So I'm gonna break down 8 factorial until I hit 6 factorial. So 8 times 7 times 6 factorial. And then I know I can cancel this 6 factorial with this one in the denominator. But what about this 2 factorial? There's no one to cancel it with. So I'm just gonna have to write it out, but don't fret. I mean, 2 factorial is not bad. It's just 2 times 1, you know? Okay, so this 6 factorial is gone. Then I just have 8 times 7 divided by 2 times 1. We can actually cancel more. This 2 cancels, and now the 8 becomes a 4. Very good. So then I have 4 times 7 divided by 1, which you probably already know, 28. Good? Okay, here's one. My teachers would love to put on the exam because even if we had a calculator, usually it would have overflow error if you didn't know this trick for how to cancel the factorials. So if you sat there like a little chump trying to plug in 100 factorial in your calculator. At least the calculators that I had to use back when I was in school, they weren't as sophisticated as the ones there are today. All right, we're breaking down the larger one until we hit 98 factorial. You don't want to write down 100 factorial until you hit 2 factorial. That would be wild. Okay, here we go. We got 100 times 99 times 98 factorial over 98 factorial. And then I go, oh, there's nobody to cancel with this 2 factorial. So I'm just going to write it as 2 times 1. And then now you get to have yourself a little cancel party, which is my favorite time. Cancel, cancel. Anything else you can cancel? Yes, the 2 and the 100. Now this becomes 50. So all we're left with is 50 times 99, which is 4,000. 950. Okay. Now, it's also important to be able to simplify variable expressions that involve factorials, especially when you're in calculus. So let's try some of those. So here we have n plus 2 factorial divided by n factorial. Now, n plus 2 factorial is the larger factorial expression. So that's the one I'm going to expand. So you have n plus 2. What's one integer smaller than n plus 2? Just keep subtracting 1. What would come next is n plus 1. I'm going to keep going until I hit n factorial to cancel. So 1 smaller than n plus 1 would just be n factorial. I'm going to stop there because I spy with my little eye an n factorial in the denominator. Good? Beautiful. And then you just cancel, cancel. And we're left with n plus 2 times n plus 1. Now, depending on what you're doing with these factorials, you might need to multiply that out, or you might just want to leave it in factored form. I'm just going to stop here in this video because we're not doing anything else with them, so this is good enough. Okay, here's another one, kind of similar. N plus 3 factorial over n plus 1 factorial and 2 factorial. So which is the largest factorial expression? It's n plus 3 factorial, right? So that's the one we're going to break down. So that's n plus 3. One integer smaller would be n plus 2. One integer smaller, n plus 1, but I see n plus 1 factorial on the other side. So I'm just going to stop there and write n plus 1 factorial. And then I'm so excited. I know this guy's going to cancel. And then there's nobody to cancel with the 2 factorial, so you don't cry. You just write it as 2 times 1. Okay, then yay. Let's cancel out n plus 1 factorial. Nothing else can cancel. So you're just going to leave it with these two factors up here, and then 2 times 1 is just 2. So this is n plus 3 times n plus 2 over 2. Fun. Okay, I only got 10 of them for you. And then after this, you're a pro. Look at that. What else have you mastered so quickly in your life? Here we go. N plus 4 factorial over n plus 2 factorial and n plus 1 factorial. So which is the largest factorial expression? Yeah, n plus 4 factorial. So let's break that one down. That's going to be n plus 4. One integer smaller would be n plus 3. Keep going. N plus 2. Stop there. Factorial. Because here's n plus 2 factorial. Now, what do I do with this n plus 1 factorial? Nothing. Sadly. We're stuck with it. Okay, so n plus 2 factorial cancels. And that's all the canceling that I can do. If I keep going, everything's just going to get smaller and I'll never be able to cancel these guys out. So we're just stuck with them. I know. This one wasn't as satisfying as the others. But it is what it is, right? We just have to say, oh, well, it's correct. Even if I don't like how it turned out, we have to move on with our lives. Okay, let's spice it up a little bit. 2n minus 2 factorial over 2n factorial. Which is the larger of the two factorial expressions? 2n factorial, right? Don't let the 2 freak you out. Please don't. 2n factorial is 2n times, what's 1 smaller? 2n minus 1. Keep going. 2n minus 2, 2n minus 3, 2n minus 4. But I'm going to stop here because next is 2n minus 2 factorial, which I see right on the other side. Boom. And then we're ready to cancel. Now this time I have a 1 left in the numerator. And then in the denominator we've got 2n times 2n minus 1. Good? Perfect. Okay, last one. N plus 1 factorial times 2n factorial over 2n plus 2 factorial times n factorial. So I want you to observe between 2n factorial and 2n plus 2 factorial, this is the larger one. So this is the one I'm going to break down. And then between n plus 1 factorial and n factorial, n plus 1 factorial is the larger one. So that's the one I'm going to break down. I won't be able to cancel n factorial with anything from 2n factorial or vice versa. So don't try to mess with it. Okay? So I'm only going to break down the ones I highlighted. So n plus 1 factorial is n plus 1 times n factorial. And then just leave that 2n factorial up there. Shall I? Here, this the yellow became this. We got it? Okay, and then 2n plus 2 factorial is 2n plus 2 times 2n plus 1. And then I'll only write one more, 2n factorial, because I see 2n factorial on the other side. And then I still have n factorial. Okay, so n plus 1 factorial is right here. And 2n plus 2 factorial is right here. How are we doing? Okay, good. Let me get rid of the highlighted part so it's not so messy. And then now we can have ourselves a little cancel party. And you guys, it's going to be epic. Look at this cancel party. 2n factorial is gone. Boom. N factorial is also gone. Boom. We can cancel something else. But maybe you don't see it. So let me rewrite what we've got. We have n plus 1 in the numerator. 2n plus 2, you guys, I could take a 2 out and write that as 2 times n plus 1 quantity, and then I still have 2n plus 1, yeah? And one more thing to cancel, that n plus 1 is gone. So then now I have 1 over 2 times 2n plus 1. Okay, cool. If you were able to keep up with that last example, then you're set. Especially if you're a Calc 2 student, I pulled that from a ratio test problem. Okay, hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up. If you found it helpful, let me know, have you seen factorials before this video? What math class are you in? Are you an algebra student pre-calc or are you a Calc student? I'm always curious who's watching these videos. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you aren't already subscribed. I have also full-length video lectures on pretty much every topic from Calc 1, 2, and 3, and then some review video lectures for trig, pre-calc, introductory to statistics, and lots of differential equations and linear algebra videos if you're a member of my YouTube channel. You can also follow me on Instagram, TikTok, see what shenanigans I'm up to throughout the day. And thank you guys so much for your support. I love you all. I'll be back sooner than later. Bye.